Hello, hi, my dear friends. Welcome to my channel HSR by Info. Today we are going to discuss an important topic, that is hormonal regulation of the digestion. Hormonal regulation of digestion. So let us see initially what is hormone. So hormones are the chemical messengers. They are act on the different organs and different cells of the human body, and it stimulates the function of organs or cells. It stimulates the function of organs and cells. Generally, these hormones, based on the site of action, based on the site of action, these hormones divide into three types. One is the autocrine, second one is the paracrine, third one is the endocrine. So come to the autocrine. Autocrine is the situation where hormones which is released by the one type of cells. For example, this is a cells. This cell releases the hormones, chemical messengers. Again, this hormones act on the same cell, that type of condition which is called as a autocrine situation. Whereas coming to the paracrine, for example, there are two cells, they are very adjacent to each other. The cell 1, cell 2. Cell 1 produces the hormones. These hormones that act on the adjacent cell 2, that is called as a paracrine situation. Here, the endocrine situation is the condition where the organ or cell which produces the hormones, these hormones act on the cells that is far away from the where secretion is started. For example, this cell or gland produces the hormones. These hormones act on this cell, or these hormones maybe act on this, maybe act on this. Like this, here the distant place, the hormones secreted at the one place, they move from where to the distance place, and there the action will be takes place. That is called as a endocrine situation. So again, these hormones divide into the two types based on the origin of hormones. Origin of hormones, these hormones again divide into two types. One is the glands, second one is the cells. We know very well there are many glands in our body. They are secreting different kinds of hormones into bloodstream. They include the hypothalamus, pituitary, pancreas, and etc. There are many glands, kidney cells also producing some hormones, adrenal glands and so on. There are many glands which are present in our body. Here coming to these cells, the cells which are producing the hormones, especially they are present in the gastrointestinal place. These cells also called as the entero endocrines. Entero endocrines. Okay, in this topic we are going to look at the gastrointestinal hormones which are secreted by the gastrointestine. These gastrointestine means gastro is a gastric place, that nothing but stomach. Intestine means that is a small intestine. The two places, small intestine and stomach, they producing the hormones. These hormones also called as the local hormones because they are secreted by the these two regions and they act on the same gut. They act on the regions of the gut. That's why this is called as a local hormones. Okay, let us see how many types of hormones they are producing. Initially, see gastric hormones. Gastric hormones, nothing but stomach, they are producing the hormones. Which type of hormones they are producing? See, the gastric hormones, they includes the ghrelin, gastrin and somatostatin. Ghrelin, gastrin and somatostatin. Coming to the intestinal hormone. Intestinal hormones. So, in the intestinal hormones includes secretin, cholecystokinin, gastric inhibitory, peptide and motilin, villikinin, enterokinin, enteronin. So these are the hormones, list of hormones they are producing from the gastric place and also intestinal regions. They include the ghrelin, gastrin, somatostatin from the stomach, and also secretin, cholecystokinin, gastric inhibitory peptide, motilin, villikinin and enteronin. These are the hormones they are producing from the intestinal hormones. So now we are going to see the what are the functions they are belongs to the these gastric hormones and intestinal hormones. So let us start with the ghrelin. So, this ghrelin is a hormone which is secreted by the mucosa of the gastrin or stomach. Though, see, actually this ghrelin that stimulates the appetite and intense hungry. Appetite and intense hungry. This hormone is more at the before feeding and it decreases at after feeding. These are the functions of the ghrelin. The main function is the stimulates the appetite and intense hungry, and also it increases at the before feeding, it decreases at the after feeding. These are the functions that are coincide that are present in the ghrelin. Coming to the next hormone, that is gastrin. Gastrin hormone. Gastrin hormone, it is secreted by the G cells of stomach. It stimulates the initial production. It stimulates the production of the HCL from the cells of the stomach. And also, it influences the growth of stomach and also stimulates the motility of stomach. It also regulates the sphincters which are associated with the stomach. Initially, it induces the contraction of cardiac sphincter. Or lower esophageal sphincter. Lower esophageal sphincter. And this hormone induces the relaxation of pyloric sphincter. Relaxation of pyloric sphincter. Actually, this hormone is increased when acid chyme is present in the stomach. Whenever the stomach that contains the initial acid chyme, that acid chyme stimulates the production of the gastrin. That gastrin again act on the cells that are called as the G cells that are present in the stomach. These G cells induces the high excess production of the HCL. This HCL act on the food particle for the digestion purpose. Okay. So, coming to the third hormone, that is our somatostatin. This somatostatin is a hormone. This is also produced by the gastric region. This somatostatin actually act on the gastrin. It act on the gastrin hormone and inhibit the production. Inhibit the production of this gastrin. So, in this way, gastrin, ghrelin and somatostatin are the three hormones that are produced by the gastric region. It is clear. So, let us see what are the intestinal hormones and what their function are. Okay. Secretin. So, secreted hormone is released by the duodenum. Duodenum, especially trips of Leberkins. Trips of Leberkins, the cells which are present in the S cells, especially S cells of trips of Leberkins, that are present in the duodenum, their cells produces the secretin hormone. This secretin hormone production is stimulated by the acid chyme. Acid chyme. Actually, acid chyme from the stomach that enter into the duodenum, that acid chyme induces the highest production of the secretin from the this duodenum region. Actually, the function of secretin, the function of secretin is it inhibit the acids in stomach. It inhibit the acids in the stomach. It also stimulates the production of water plus bicarbonates. Water and bicarbonates from the pancreas. The next, it stimulates hepatocytes. That means it act on the liver, that liver that contains the hepatocytes, for the production of the bile, juices. And secretin also promote effects of cholecystokinin. Okay. So these are the functions which are done by the secretin hormone. Okay. Coming to the next hormone, that is the cholecystokinin. Actually, this cholecystokinin also secreted by the duodenum. This secretion is stimulated by the acid chyme, especially that acid chyme contains the rich in amino acids, fatty acids and triglycerols. Whenever the acid chyme that rich in the amino acid, fatty acid, triglycerol, then the duodenum is produces the high amount of the cholecystokinin. So coming to the functions of the cholecystokinin. Actually, cholecystokinin that act on the pancreas, and stimulate the production of the pancreatic enzymes. And it also act on the liver, especially gallbladder. On the gallbladder, it stimulates the contraction for the release of the bile juices into the duodenum. Okay. And also, it relaxes the one sphincter, that is a sphincter of Oddi. So these are the functions, they are associated with the cholecystokinin hormone which is produced by the duodenum. So the next hormone, gastric inhibitory peptide, simply called as a GIP. This gastric inhibitory peptide also produced by the duodenum. So this hormone secretion is stimulated by the acid chyme, especially acid chyme that contains the food resources rich in food sources like glucose, fatty acid plus triglycerols. Whenever the acid can rich in the glucose, fatty acid, triglycerol, then gastric inhibitory peptide is secreted by the duodenum. Okay, actually the functions of gastric inhibitory peptide is it inhibits the gastric juices. It inhibits the gastric juices production. Actually, gastric juices are produced by the stomach. So, this enzyme, this hormone that acts on the stomach and inhibits the gastric juices production. So, this hormone also has a specialized functions. They include the, it acts on the pancreatic, it acts on the pancreatic endocrine cells. Especially beta isolates and induces the production of the insulin. It stimulates the production of the insulin simply. So, it also promotes the lipogenesis by the adipose cells. It promotes the lipogenesis by the adipose cells. It means formation of the lipid layer in the adipose tissue. And another function of the GIP is it induces the skeletal muscle. It induces the skeletal muscle for the uptaking of glucose. Uptaking of glucose. These are the functions which are associated with the GIP. So, the next hormone is the motilin. So, motilin is a hormone which is secreted by the small intestine. This secretion is stimulated by the acid chyme. So, actually this motilin is act on the stomach and small intestine smooth muscles. Smooth muscles. So, motilin that promote the production of acid. Motilin that promote the production of acids from the stomach. These are the two important functions which are associated with the motilin. So, coming to the villikinin. Villikinin. Villikinin is a hormone which is secreted by the microvilli of small intestine. Microvilli of small intestine. This actually is essential for the movement of the microvilli. Movement of microvilli. This movement which increases the absorption capacity of the microvilli. These are the function which associated with the microvilli producing villikinin. The final enzyme is the enterocrinin. Enterocrinin. So this enterocrinin also produced by the small intestinal cells. This enterocrinin crinin actually essential for the succus entericus productions. Succus entericus secretion productions. The secretions which are secreted by the succus entericus is influenced by the enterocrinin. So this is the only the function of the enterocrinin which are present or associated with the small intestine. These are the hormones which are associated with the all the which are scattered in the cells which present in the gastric and small intestine. Okay, it is clear. So the next topic is the calorific value of carbohydrates, proteins and lipids. Calorific value of carbohydrates, proteins and lipids. So what are the calorific value which present for the carbohydrates, proteins and lipids? See, carbohydrates and proteins. Carbohydrates, proteins, calorific value is the same. Here 1 gram of carbohydrates or 1 gram of protein which gives the calories 4 kilocalories or 4000 calories or 4 kilocalories for the 1 gram of carbohydrates and 1 gram of proteins. Whereas coming to the lipids that gives the highest calorific value when compared to the carbohydrates and proteins. Let us see, 1 gram of lipid that produces the 9 kilocalories of the calorific value. So here 9 kilocalories are 9000 calories. So this is very important. On the basis of these values, they frame the questions in the NEET exam. Okay, so please do make notes. Okay, and this is a very important, and they're giving these hormones and where they are producing, and also they're framing the questions multiple choice, and also they're framing the questions as the matching. So please do concentrate on these concepts. Okay, it is clear. So I hope this is very clear to understand. If you really understood this class, please do subscribe my channel HSR by Info.